Hi, I'm Harlan Charles. I'm the Corvette product manager, sitting in front of the first generation Corvette, started in 1953, designed by Harley Earl. This car was shown at the Motorama and was really a dream car. It caused a sensation and actually went into production 6 months later. And actually, our famous chief engineers, or Arkus Dontov, saw this car and thought it was a great, that America was doing a sports car, but thought, you know what, I can take this and make it into a world-class performance car that can take on the best in Europe. So you look at this car, some of the neat things about it, the stone guards, which are popular on race cars at the time to protect the headlamps from stone chips and things like that. This car had a six-cylinder engine when we started, the Blue Flame 6, 150 horsepower. In 1955, the small block V8 was introduced, was a big part of the performance of this car as well. This generation of Corvette ran all the way to 1962. One of the neat things that happened, 1960, the Corvette went to Le Mans for the first time, the 24 hours, and won its class. This is the second generation Corvette, the Stingray. In 1959, there was a race car called the Stingray. It really influenced Bill Mitchell's design by deep sea fishing. And actually, 1963 came out with a car heavily influenced by that race car as the Corvette Stingray. This car actually featured some new technology. Independent rear suspension came out a little bit later on. We got four-wheel disc brakes. This car is a 66. This one has the famous 427 big block engine, which ran from 66 all the way to 69, up to 435 horsepower. And really, the Corvette now with the sophisticated handling could really compete very well. And actually, Bob Bondurant and Dick Gulfstrand took a Corvette in 67 to Le Mans. This is the third generation Corvette. It came out in 1968, heavily influenced by the Mako Shark show car. In 68, it ran all the way to 1982, was really the longest running of the Corvette generations. It really made it through a lot of times from in our history, everything from the muscle car era through kind of the tough times in the 70s, whereas the importance of emissions and fuel economy, all the way to, into the 80s. Now this car is a LT1, it's a 72, and the LT1 is was the powerful small block V8. It was a 350 cubic inch. And Corvette really did also well, continued racing into the 70s in Sebring and also with the real flamboyant race cars of that era. This generation actually kept the Stingray name all the way up until 1976. And for a lot of people with the aggressive fenders and the shapes in this car, this is really the Corvette. When you close your eyes and you think of Corvette, this is kind of the shape a lot of people will think of. This is the fourth generation Corvette, or C4. Came out as a 1984 model, actually came out in 1983. This car was long awaited, as the third generation had been such a long generation, and really wanted to bring the Corvette up and back into being a very high performance sports car. The car had a clamshell hood. It had tune port injection. This car is an 86 convertible. The convertible had previously been discontinued after 75. Convertible came right back in 86. The car also had complete electronic instrumentation in the interior, very much ahead of its time. And during the life cycle of the fourth generation, the ZR1 came out in 1990, with ultimately ended up with 405 horsepower. Another new technology that came out with the 80s Corvette is the real dive into aerodynamics. This car at 0.34 drag for its day was a very low drag car as well, and it became a bottom breather with everything sealed up in the front. And also the hidden lights are very unique too, as they could do a 180 degree turn and actually kept the smooth fairing in even when the headlights were up. Okay, this is the fifth generation Corvette, or C5, came out in 1997. Really had a lot of new technology. It really changed the way even automobiles were manufactured. Had a hydroformed steel frame, which really eliminated a lot of welding and parts and reduced weight. Also, we moved the transmission to the rear of the car, which gave it a 50-50 weight distribution, weight balance. Also, this car we're standing in front of is a 2001 Z06. The Z06 became a high performance, even a higher performance model in the Corvette lineup, ultimately getting 405 horsepower. This is sixth generation Corvette, or C6. Came out in 2005 and ran up until this year, 2013, which we're standing by, you know, celebrating the 60th anniversary of Corvette. You know, the focus on the sixth generation Corvette was really to take the car leaner and meaner. We reduced the length of the car 5 inches to really keep it tight so it could compete with the best of Europe, and also reduced weight of the car as well. Through the life cycle, we came out again with the Z06 model, now with a 7-liter 427 cubic inch engine with 505 horsepower, and then in 09 the ZR1 returned with a supercharged 638 horsepower version. Also introduced during the sixth generation was aluminum frame structure on the Z06 and ZR1 and carbon fiber panels. Now here we are, 2014 Corvette Stingray, 7th generation, only the 7th all-new generation in 60 years of Corvette history. Very exciting. The car has a new LT1 engine, 460 horsepower. We have functional aerodynamics that you can see from Corvette racing. You see the hood vent on the hood actually helps downforce, and the cooling vents over the rear quarters or fenders cool the transmission and the rear differential. And this car is also has the latest technology, and it comes standard with aluminum frame, and is capable of an incredible 29 miles per gallon while still doing 0 to 60 in 3.8 seconds. The Corvette has always been my favorite car growing up, and one of the things that I realized at a young age, you know, my dad was into sports cars, and I'd get sports car books and from Europe and things like that. And one of the things I realized, you know, they have the little country where every car is from. The only American car you'd ever see mentioned was the Chevrolet Corvette, and I always had a sense of pride about that. And being able to be a part of this car and work on this car is really a dream come true for me. I think the Corvette is really not only a proof point for Chevrolet and GM, but I think it's really, you know, an icon for the whole American auto industry to show that we can build a world-class sports car and win. You can see how the Corvette evolves. There's certain things that always stay true. Of course, it's a two-seat, high-performance sports car with technology that's fun to drive. But we don't keep the same look as some others, the same exact styling. We've really tried to make the car all new. So this car is an all new car, the new Corvette Stingray. But when you see it, everybody instantly knows it is the new Corvette. And that's really the fun thing about it. We're able to change everything on the car. This only has two parts carry over from the previous Corvette, but yet everybody knows as soon as they look at it, it is the new Corvette.